International cricket returns tomorrow. You're very excited.
Very excited.
England begin their three-match test series against the West Indies, the first match since the start of the pandemic.
But it won't be quite as we remember it. There won't be fans in the crowd. Wiping saliva on the ball is banned and players sanitising their hands will become a common sight. Well, joining us from Hampshire is the West Indies head coach, Phil Simmons. Phil, great to have you on the programme this morning. How are you?
I'm good, Jess. Thanks for having me.
So I was with Kevin Peterson at the weekend and he was saying this is going to really be fascinating to work out how players react to playing in front of an empty stadium. What do you think? Because some players, you can imagine, they thrive. I'm thinking of someone like Ben Stokes, for example, who's captain of England in this game because Joe Root's off because his wife's having a baby. That some players, they thrive from that adrenaline that comes from a crowd getting more excited. Can they do it without the crowd?
Well, it's left to be seen. And you've given a perfect example there in Ben. He needs it. Well, I didn't say he needs it, but he thrives on it. We, on the other hand, sometimes we play test cricket and there's not many people in the stadiums in the Caribbean. So I don't think it will affect us as much. The difference here is that we usually get good support here too, but I think it's harder on the England players because they're always playing in front of sellout crowds here.
So you might actually benefit from that. I wonder if you've watched any of the football matches which have been playing without crowds because, you know, some people have described them with as much atmosphere as a training game. It is pretty tough for the players to really step up when there's no one there supporting them.
Yeah, it is. It has been hard. It looks difficult, but we've still seen some good football. And I think as a player, when you out there, if it's not your home crowd, you tend to try and block out the crowd and just focus on what you have to do out there. So I think it's a little bit different for the cricket, but hopefully we see the players thrive on this and lift their game.
Now, coronavirus, Phil, has been the backdrop for all of this, of course, and I'm thrilled we're getting any kind of cricket going. It's been a long, hard battle, like it has for many sports. You yourself got caught up in this because, very sadly, your father-in-law died and you wanted, quite understandably, to attend the funeral. And that led to some backlash back home, didn't it? Tell us about what happened there.
Backlash. One of the board members decided to write a letter to ask for my dismissal because I've broken the biosecure unit to attend the funeral of my father-in-law, which I've gotten to the stage where the more I think about it, the sadder it sounds to me. But he just showed his agendas and that's all I can take from it.
I think the thing is that a lot of people, of course, have found funerals in particular quite a difficult issue, haven't they? Because, of course, what your whole family human instinct is to attend the funeral of a loved one, and yet it's been wrapped up in so many rules, as you yourself found.
Yeah, it's been a situation where people pay their respect, especially in our culture. The church would be full, the cemetery would be full. But on this occasion, we only allowed 20. But it's just been something that's been used. I could understand if I went to a wedding or something, which wasn't fully necessary. But something like that, especially how close my wife is to her dad, or was to her dad, it, for me, it's just sad.
I thought it was pathetic, honestly, Phil. And sad is an understatement. It was pathetic. You guys should just get a life. And you've had multiple tests since. It's obviously been very safe for you. How concerned are you? I mean, there was a lot of fear that the ball, the cricket ball itself, the British Prime Minister said it could be a vector for the virus. They now seem to have decided it isn't. But players not being able to use spit on the ball, it would have been, you know, for a century or more, a key way of getting the ball to move around, to swing and so on. How much of an impact will that have on Test cricket?
Well, we spent the first 2 weeks we were here trying to make sure that our players don't use the saliva because it's something we grew up on. You use that, you know, as soon as you start bowling, you start using saliva to shine the ball. In the Caribbean, we would sweat. here it's a little more difficult to sweat. I mean, down Hampshire here it might be all right. Old Trafford, I'm not too sure, but
you might get rain.
We've got to find a way. And over the last couple of weeks, while we were training up in Manchester, guys have been looking at different ways of doing it. I mean, sweating would be the ideal solution, but I think we have to find a way while we're on the field.
The other issue is obviously the backdrop of the horrific murder of George Floyd in America and the Black Lives Matter protests. We know the England team will join the West Indies in having the Black Lives Matter logo on their playing shirts. There's been a lot of controversy here, Phil, about the two different Black Lives Matter movements, if you like. One, the political organisation, which has quite inflammatory political views, and one, the hashtag Black Lives Matter, which I think the vast majority of people have been supporting. Are you concerned at all about the politicisation of that phrase, Black Lives Matter?
Yeah, I wouldn't like to see it politicised to the point where it gets ridiculous. I think it is something that we have been living with for a long time, and I think it's something that rightfully has to be challenged and has to be, people have to be educated and things move forward. So I hope that it's used in the correct way and helped me to move things forward.
The issue that goes with it is taking the knee. Carlos Brathwaite, one of the West Indies stars, says sports people taking the knee is cosmetic and that legislative change is needed to really combat racial equality. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, totally. I think you're taking a knee. It's not. I wouldn't say it's cosmetic. It's showing that you are supporting the challenge. But at the same time, it's not just for now. That's one of the discussions we had as a team. We're not just going to do this now while we're here, and then when you go back home, it changes. We need to continue this, and the world needs to continue this and continue pushing for equality, let's say.
Yeah.
Well, listen, it's great to talk to you. You're a great chap. We've known each other over the years, but I wish you nothing but abject failure on the cricket pitch. You would expect nothing else from me.
That was utterly graceless.
I want Ben Stokes and the boys to give you guys a good thrashing, and I can't pretend otherwise. Sorry, Phil.
May the best men win.
Don't worry, I'll get in touch with you at the end, Piers.
Fighting talk from Phil Simmons on behalf of the West Indies team. It was a great, great series. Great to see cricket back, Phil, and all the very best to you and the team as you spend your time in England.
Thank you, guys. Thank you very much.
So nice to see you.
It's going to be a good series, actually. It's going to be good. I mean, Joe Root not playing in the first test. Going to be doing, you know, with his wife as she gives birth. Stokes, captain of England. Interesting thing. Can your best player, who's so dominant with fielding and batting and bowling, actually be a captain with all that responsibility too? It didn't work for some others, Ian Botham and others. Can it work for Ben Stokes?
And with no fans there.
No fans.
And you can't spit on the ball.
Nope. It's going to be very strange.